Hey guys, it's your girl Carrie, and today I will be sharing the highly requested Dollar Tree Tablescape video. I'm also going to add a little twist to this video. It's also going to be a Tablescape Basics 101 video where I share what you would need to create that perfect tablescape. It's going to take you from, you know, the person that has absolutely nothing. Say you're that college student moving into your first apartment and you want to feel grown up. So if you have absolutely nothing, or maybe you're a mom and your toddlers are older now and you want to get rid of all that plastic and sippy cups and you're thinking, where do I start? Or you're that newlywed couple that wants to, you know, start decorating your home. So this is a basic tablescape, what you need, and I'm going to show you how to build it up. Now, looking at all the items on this table right now, if you wanted to do a place setting for four people, like if your table held four people, to purchase all of these items, it is going to cost $155. Now, if you needed a place setting for eight people, this table setting will cost you $221. Now, before you drop your jaw and say, Carrie, I thought this was supposed to be a Dollar Tree video on how to do a tablescape. Again, I'm going to break it down into components. What would you buy with your first $50? And then how do you grow from there to get all the components that you need to make a lovely and lush tablescape? So let's get started. Now, my table is broken down into three sections. And this first section right here, this first third of the table, are all the items that I purchased from the Dollar Tree. The second section, all of the items in here cost a dollar, but they were not purchased from the Dollar Tree. So I will share with you how to break things down and where to get things from for a dollar that is not at the Dollar Tree. And then this third section over here are items that you will need for your tablescape, but they're not a dollar. They're going to cost a little bit more than a dollar. So let's get started with our Dollar Tree section. Now, first up, when getting your table setting, you're going to need to buy a place setting where you have your plates, your bowls, your mugs, and things like that. Now, most experts will probably tell you if you're going to be buying your first basic set is to buy white, because white can mix in and it's versatile and, you know, it can mix with any and everything. That is true, but you don't always have to go with white. What I say is buy neutral. If you don't want to buy white, buy neutral, because neutral pieces can be mixed and matched with so many things. And I will show you a ton of ways that you can mix this neutral taupe place setting and get totally different looks. Another tip that I would recommend when purchasing your first or your basic everyday dishware is to make sure not only that it's neutral, but that it is unadorned or the adornments are understated. And what I mean by that, this one has a beautiful beading, a raised beading on it with a raised line going around it. It's gorgeous, but it's understated. It's not going to take away from the plate or anything like that. You do not want to buy as your main place setting or your everyday place setting something that has a busy pattern on it. Like, let's say you like butterflies or you like birds or something like that, and it's all plastered all over the plate, because then that's going to limit you to what you can do and how you can, you know, arrange your setting. And instead of getting something that has a pattern all over it, you can use your patterns through your fabrics and things like that, maybe your napkins or something like that. So make sure that it is either simply adorned or unadorned and plain, so that you can have that versatility. Now, as far as the number of place settings you should buy, my rule of thumb is to, if you have more than two spaces in which you eat, let's say you have a formal dining room and an eat-in kitchen, I would buy a place setting that would fit the largest table. So let's say your dining room fits or serves eight. Buy eight place settings. Now, if you only have one area in which you eat, let's say that place, that table seats six, then you would go ahead and buy the six place settings plus two more if it's not a white plain place setting, because you can always replace white. But let's say a place setting like this, you may not be able to find it again. So go ahead and buy the six plus two more. So if you break it, you will still have the extras in order to complete your place setting. Now, the reason I say only by eight, if you have two places, the largest table, if you break a, you know, one of the place settings there, you still have your eat-in kitchen. So you would still have a full complete place setting to use for your eat-in kitchen. And then that way, this would become your eat-in kitchen area place setting. And then you would build or maybe get a white set or something like that for your formal dining room. Or you can mix and match. If you're not afraid to mix and match, then you can still mix and match the pieces that, you know, are broken. Now, looking down here, here are your mugs. We're going to look at your drinkware. What drinkware do you need to get? Basic drinkware from the Dollar Tree. Here you have the mugs, and the mugs actually, you know, come with the place setting. You would buy, you know, either 4, 8, however many you need for your place setting. And mugs are typically used in the morning for your breakfast, whether it's juice, coffee, tea, or if, you know, you want hot chocolate or something like that, those are what your mugs are used for, and that's just, you know, casual. Now, as far as glassware, you want to start off with your stemless wine glass. I think this provides the most versatility, and the Dollar Tree has 3 different sizes and styles of the stemless wine glass. Here's a smaller one here. It has kind of like that European shape, and, you know, this is a little bit larger one, and here's the largest. I think this one holds like 28 ounces of liquid. And why I say the stemless wine glass is probably the most versatile and the most important of the glasses that you're going to get if you had to, you know, choose and your money was limited, is because this can serve as a wine glass if you don't drink wine. This can also be a juice glass in the morning. You can set that out on the table. This can also serve as kind of like a candle holder. You can fit a small candle in here. These can be like votive candle holders. This can also be a small vase, so you can put a small floral arrangement in it. These right here are workhorses. You can also use this if you don't have the proper condiment, you know, trays or vessels. You can, you know, put your ketchup in here or whatever it is, because, you know, you don't want to put the actual bottle of anything, you know, on the table. You want to pour it into a vessel and scoop it out. So these could work well for that, especially the smaller glasses. So the stemless wine glass is my first choice if I had to choose a glass, and the only glass that I could have. The next type of glass you would want to buy from the Dollar Tree is just the straight cylinder type glass. And basically this is kind of called a Collins glass, or you can also purchase one that's called the highball. The highball is a little bit wider and straight up, but this is perfect for, again, mixed drinks, either mocktails or cocktails. This is great for like lemonade, and you can put a nice little straw on this, sit it on a tray, take it outside. This also is a workhorse, and this is a beautiful glass. You can also use this as a floral arrangement. And then the last glass you will need is an all-purpose wine glass. And again, you don't need to get a red wine glass, a white wine glass, all the different types of wine glasses. Just get one that's all-purpose, and then you can build from there. So just to recap the different types of basic glassware that you would need when you're starting off: a mug, a wine glass, a tall glass, Collins or a highball, and a stemless wine glass. And I think I forgot to mention, the small stemless wine glasses are also perfect for desserts and parfaits. The next item you're going to want to get from the Dollar Tree is this beautiful vessel right here. And basically what I use this for is syrup. You can just pour your syrups in here and set this out on your table for breakfast. And this also is good for salad dressing. So if you want to pour your salad dressing in here, or if you made a homemade, you know, from scratch salad dressing, it would be perfect to put in here and put on your table for lunch if you had a salad for lunch and you were serving lunch. So these are perfect. Or you can also use them for oil and vinegar. So pick these up from the Dollar Tree as well. Now let's look at our middle section, where everything here is a dollar, but it did not come from Dollar Tree. Now I would say, do not purchase any of the flatware from Dollar Tree. None of the flatware in Dollar Tree is of, you know, any good quality. Everything there is subpar. So a place where you can get a good, everyday, inexpensive flatware set is Walmart. The Better Homes and Gardens line sells a really, really nice set of flatware. It's very plain. It's, you know, unadorned, but it can go with everything. I really like this set. And I've had it for several years now. And each piece, when I purchased it, they came two in a pack for $1.50. So each piece ran about 75 cents. I think now they're still selling at Walmart, but I want to say it's individually, you know, individual pieces, and I think they're $1 a piece now. So they went up in price, but don't quote me on that, but check it out. It's a Better Homes and Gardens brand, and I think this is a really good starter point for you if you do not have any flatware. The next item are more condiment servers, and this right here you can put your butter in if you have butter, ketchup, whatever it is that you're serving, if it's breakfast, lunch, and dinner, whatever you need to, you know, put in these vessels, you can put them in there. And I picked these up for $1. Actually, they were $1.99 for two. Over here are napkin rings. Again, napkin rings just add that little extra special flair. They're not necessary, but as you're building things up, you probably want some napkin rings. And these right here are really nice. They're natural. You know, I love natural materials. And they're a little bit contemporary and funky because they're in a square shape. I think these are really nice. And these were $1 a piece, and I picked these up from an antique flea market. Now my number one tip, and if you guys have been following me for any time and watched any of my tablescapes, I absolutely love fabric. Fabric is the most inexpensive way, but the most impactful way to switch up your tablescapes and give them a completely different look. And so this fabric right here, I actually pulled out of my craft room and, you know, matched it up to the set. And a yard of fabric can go a long way. I typically get all of my fabric for $3.99 a yard or less. I go to a discount fabric place here in Atlanta, and they sell the best fabrics. Fabrics that you would find for $25 a yard, $40 a yard. Absolutely the best, but everything is $3.99 or less. And this particular fabric, I had a yard of it. I had my mom cut out four squares. So with a yard of fabric, you can get four napkins and a runner. So again, that ends up being less than $1 a piece for the napkins and the runner, and you're going to get high quality, you know, materials. You can also make no-sew napkins and no-sew runners. Again, do not buy anything that is fabric related from the Dollar Tree because it is poor quality. The next thing you're going to need are salt and pepper shakers. I picked these salt and pepper shakers up on clearance at Hobby Lobby a couple of years back, and they ran me $1 for the set. And the next item you're going to need is something to put your drinks in. So these two carafes here, you can pick carafes up from everywhere nowadays, and they can run you anywhere from $1 on up to $3.99. I picked these up from, I think, a thrift store or Goodwill. They were $1 each. And they did not have the tops, and I picked up these little cork tops for the carafes from IKEA. IKEA also sells carafes, and these little cork tops are 79 cents in IKEA. And so that goes right on there. And then behind there actually is a pitcher that I picked up from the on clearance at Marshall's, and that was $3.99. And I just stuck in some floral sprigs that I picked up on clearance. I can't remember what store because I had them for years, and they were under $3 for all those little sprigs. And then finally back there, we want to talk about the placemats. Well, the Dollar Tree has placemats that are similar to this, and I think they come in funky colors like orange and the blue. Do not purchase the placemats from there. Those placemats are inferior and they look cheap. So what I would recommend is going into like Home Goods, TJ Maxx, places like that, Burlington, and looking for other placemat alternatives. Now, this placemat here, I absolutely love it. I love the way it's made. I love the color. I love the sheen. It just feels really good. And I picked up four of these in a pack for $3.99. So again, if you break down, you know, the packaging, like, okay, if it's four in a pack and there's $3.99, that's $1 each. I'm coming out the same, you know, price that I would have paid for that cheap looking Dollar Tree one. But I'm getting better quality. So don't always think Dollar Tree, oh, it's cheap. Break things apart and see if it, sometimes you end up cheaper than the Dollar Tree. So I love these placemats. We'll see how they fit into our overall tablescape. Now over here, I just have some three faux topiary balls, and these can run you anywhere from $3.99 to $7.99, $9.99, depending on how large a ball you get. But this is a pretty good size ball, and I picked these up for, I think they were $4.99 from TJ Maxx or Marshalls. Then over here, we have our serving vessels, like our baking dishes. I only have one here because the space on the table didn't allow for it. But if you had like a baking dish, a lasagna pan, or anything like that, a ceramic baking dish, this right here is a beautiful dish that I picked up 2 years ago from Hobby Lobby clearance. It was 90% off. It was originally $44. I got this dish for $4, and I just love the detail on it. This is perfect for, you know, holding bread, soups, stews, whatever. So, you know, get your baking dishes, and you can get baking dishes anywhere from like $3.99 up to $12.99. So whatever your needs are, whatever you're cooking, you're going to need some sort of bakeware to serve your food in. Again, you guys have seen this riser on my budget-friendly Easter tablescape. Risers just add another element or dimension to your table so everything doesn't look flat. And I picked that up from a thrift store for under $10 a while back. And then down here are these wrought iron heaters. So this kind of keeps your food warm. You put the tea light candles underneath it, and you sit your, you know, your ceramic, you know, baking dish on top to keep your food hot. And these can also act as risers too. And these were $12.99. I picked them up from Home Goods some years ago. And that will also look great on your table to keep your food hot. Last item you're going to need are your serving utensils. And again, you probably have to build up to this to get a nice set. So in the meantime, you can go ahead and get, you know, the faux silver looking serving utensils from the Dollar Tree. Buy four of them, five of them, however many you need to serve your food. But this right here is just a casual but nice, elegant looking set by Mikasa, and I absolutely love this set. And as you can see, I have a tablecloth on my table, and that was, I got on clearance for $2.99, in natural 100% cotton tablecloth. So now that I explained everything that's on the table, let's go ahead and put our table together. The first thing I'm going to show you is what $50 would get you and what the table would look like, and then we're going to just kind of build from there. So here's what a $50 tablescape would get you. This is what it would look like. So if you had nothing, none of these items, you had to go out from scratch and get everything on this table, this is what you could achieve for $50. Now looking at this, this is a good foundation. This is a good structure for a table setting. No, is it, you know, the elevated pro status where you're looking like it should be in a magazine? No, but it is doable. It does look nice. It doesn't look cheap. It still looks classy, but we can build it up. This is a great starting point. So here are our napkins, and again, you don't have to have napkin rings in order to have a nice napkin. I just took my napkin and folded it in a fashion where it's kind of like a pocket. This is called a pocket fold, and I just made sure the large part of the napkin that actually had, you know, the color that matched or blended in with my plate was showing, so that large flower is showing, and I just tucked my silverware down in the pocket. And that's one of the things you can do when you don't have napkin rings and things like that, is just fold your napkins in different ways. On this setting over here, I just folded the napkin in the standard luncheon fold. That's how you fold a napkin if you're serving lunch. So that's the standard lunch fold, and that's basically it. In the center, we didn't have enough money for a centerpiece, so what we did was use our baking dish as our centerpiece. This is our focal point. We don't have money for flowers. We only had $50. We had to get all of our So if you don't have enough money to create a centerpiece or anything like that, just make sure that the different pieces that you choose, like your baking dishes, are decorative enough that they can be used or substituted as your centerpiece. This looks beautiful there. It's on a runner. This runner is kind of a no-sew runner. I just threw this scrap piece of fabric here so that I could show you how you could put a runner there just to give it a little bit more dimension so it wouldn't look just flat on the table, because again, we don't have the money for the risers or anything like that yet that makes our tables more beautiful and more luxurious. We have our, you know, little dispensers there. And also, since we only had enough money for one baking dish because we only spent $50, we have to think about what we're going to serve. So we need to serve a one-stop shop, a one dish meal. So whether we put a salad in here and then we distributed the salad and put dressings, salad dressing in these containers here, we can just kind of like open it up and take our salads out and put it on our plate. Just make sure it's a substantial salad, maybe made with a pasta and a chicken or something like that. A one dish meal, because that's all we could afford. We only have one dish. And then we have our salt and pepper shaker over here, and we're good to go. And we just have, you know, our cups here. But since this is lunch, we would probably switch the cups out. Now let's go back and see what our tablescape looks like if we added another $50 to this table. Now here's what we have if we added an additional $50 to this table. As you can see, it looks a lot fuller and a lot more elegant. So where did the $50 go? Well, in the middle, we removed our centerpiece. Originally, we were using our, you know, baking dish as the centerpiece. Well, now we had a little bit more money to make a centerpiece. And so what I did was I took three of the bowls. You can always use your bowls as, you know, as planters, and I just stuck three of the topiaries in the bowl and lined them down the table, three of the bowls down the table. This is perfect because it's a low height. I don't have to move it or anything. We can still converse and see each other across the table. So this is a little perfect little floral arrangement for our table. Now let's look at our place setting. I was able to add in our dollar placemat, and so that gives it another dimension and another layer to this table. And I was also able to add in our dollar napkin rings, the wooden square napkin rings. So now we have a fluffy, nice, pier one looking napkin next to our place setting. And then over here, I just switched up our flatware. I purchased this flatware a couple years back at Target, I believe, and this is the bronze series. It's a bronze color. It's not copper, it's actually a bronze color, and it matches perfectly with this table setting. So I love this bronze, you know, silverware, and it looks really, really, really good with the table setting. So now our table setting is coming together. Now over here at this place setting, we have a totally different option and a little bit more layering. So what I did was I turned our napkin into a placemat. So when I had my mom make these napkins for me, I made sure it was the lunch size napkin, which is an 18 inch by 18 inch square. And that is perfect to make a square placemat. And now we can just kind of add another layer. So we have a placemat up on top of another, you know, placemat, and then our setting. And then I just took a plain napkin that, you know, I already had, rolled it up and put this napkin ring on. If you guys remember my Pier 1 haul about 2 years ago, I got these napkin rings for 48 cents, and I think they were originally $3.99. So that's another look that you can have. The versatility of, like I said, the fabric, the versatility of a napkin, it could be a napkin or a placemat, and it adds a wonderful dimension to your table for no extra money. And for this tablescape, I just paired it with this off-white flatware, and you've guys seen this flatware. So for $100, this is what you would get. So now what I'm going to do is go ahead and put all the bells and whistles on our tabletop and show you what a $155 table looks like. So we got paid again next payday, so we got another $50 to stack onto this table. Now here is my final tablescape with all of the bells and whistles that, you know, looks like a Dollar Tree Couture tablescape. And so what elevates or makes this table so much more luxurious and lush and full are the different, you know, little accessories that I added to the table, like this charger right here. This is a Pier 1 charger mixed in with all of the dollar items, just elevates it. And so everything here in this set from the napkins to the napkin rings to the actual plates and the placemat are all a dollar. Now, this is the only element that is actually, you know, on the pricey side. But, you know, again, if you get all the other elements cheaply, you can splurge on those, you know, pieces that are really unique and nice. And I also went ahead and just traded out our silverware. Again, just to kind of show you a different element, what those, you know, higher end tables look like. It's just those little bitty details that, you know, you change to make it look a little bit better. And even if I were to keep the original dollar, you know, flatware there, I still think the table would have looked equally as nice. I'm just trying to show you what is it that makes those tables pop that look like they're $1 million in the magazines. And then over here, I just added a little wine holder to hold the wine. There's little accessories like this that add a little, you know, a little bit more to your tabletop. And this is actually from Pottery Barn, and I got this little wine holder on sale, and it was under $10. I think it was $9.99 at Pottery Barn. And then I just switched out our, you know, breakfast mugs and put in just a wine glass, the Dollar Tree wine glasses. So everything just looks, you know, really, really nice. And so this would be the everyday table setting. Now, many of you are saying, Carrie, this is not an everyday table setting. This is still fancy. Again, yes, it could be a little bit overwhelming, and maybe you would just set this up for a Sunday dinner. Now you might ask, what would I do for every day? Because Carrie, I can't leave my table like this. My kids come home, they use my table for homework, and everyone gathers around and uses it for projects and things like that. I need to have room. So what do I do in that instance? So I'm going to show you how you can set the table up when you're not using it. So now I'm going to show you how you can set your table up when you're not using it for just everyday use, when you just come home from school and the kids need to use it for the table. But before I do that, here's another way I can share with you how you can also use your table. Because a lot of times people get, you know, like, hey, what's all these plates? We don't use all those plates and bowls at a setting. That doesn't make sense. What you can do is, you know, use it throughout the day for each meal. For example, if your table's set like this in the morning or what have you, if you get up and everyone eats porridge or oatmeal or something like that, you can use this bowl here for all of your oatmeal. Sit down, eat. When you finish, take it, put it in a dishwasher, and you move on for the rest of the day. So you'll be left with just this portion. And since it's summertime, people are still home for lunch. So say it's lunchtime. You come down and you make sandwiches, and you don't need to use, you know, any utensils. Your spoon is already in the sink because you used it with your porridge, or in the dishwasher rather. So you come down for lunch, you eat your sandwiches, and you're done with that. You take your plate away and you put it in the dishwasher. And so now finally you're just left with your plate, and that's what you need for dinner. So the family comes down and everyone just has their dinner plate, and when you're finished, you take that and you put that in the dishwasher. And now you've had all of your meals instead of trying to use all of these dishes at one course or one setting, like having a 5-course meal. You kind of just broke up your courses throughout the day for your breakfast, lunch, and dinner. So now let me just show you another very simple way that you can set it up that will be no fuss, no muss. Now here is a practical application for everyday use. Like you say, if this is your only table and your kids come home from school, you need to use this table as your work table. You want it to be minimalistic as possible. So what you could do is put in a caddy and have all of the plates for dinner in there, your napkins and your silverware. So when it's time to come sit down for dinner, you just pull out a plate and put it right onto your placemat. And the only thing you need to grab is the food that you're going to be cooking. Put that on the table and grab your cups. Now I have a really small giveaway that I think would fit well with this theme that I'm going with, the basic tablescape. And I have this napkin folding kit book, and I absolutely love this. It's a beautiful book, and basically you open it up, and inside on this side, it's not open yet. You just pull the tab back, and there's a napkin in there for practice. And then in this side, there's an actual book. Inside the book, it gives you details on how to, you know, make all different types of napkin folds. And then in the beginning of the book, it shows you the proper place setting, various types of place settings, whether it's a formal place setting, an informal place setting. So I think this is an awesome book for beginners. And in order to be a part of this giveaway, you need to be a subscriber to my channel. So, and leave a comment below to let me know what else you would like to know about entertaining so that I can include that information in my next basic entertaining video. So I hope this video was helpful, and I hope you guys got some tips. And until next time, I am going to keep calm and carry on. Bye, guys.